This week, Alex Ferguson singled out the five main qualities that he believes every championship team needs. Ability, concentration, determination, desire, and luck. Maybe the fact that Mark Hughes is still a Manchester United player will prove to be a significant stroke of luck, particularly today, because if he had left, he'd almost certainly be an Everton player by now. On a bare and bouncy pitch, Andrei Kanchelskis has been left on the United bench today. Dennis Irwin returns. This is a ground on which the champions have won their last three games. In fact, Everton haven't scored a Goodison goal against them for well over 5 years. What's more, their leading scorer, Paul Rideout, has been ruled out for a month, and his intended deputy, Graham Stewart, is injured too. Local boy Stuart Barlow is preferred to Daniel Amakachi. The new local hero, Duncan Ferguson, carries the main threat. Only one member of the Ferguson clan can leave Goodison the happy man tonight. Joe Worrell is the man in charge today. The Goodison Park pitch has certainly seen better days, but Everton's form on it this year has been outstanding. Five straight home wins, yielding 15 goals. And real optimism for a rousing cup run and a successful scrap with the relegation threat. Everton's needs are every bit as great as Manchester United's today. Everton have a free kick. United beat them three times last season, once already this. The rivalry between these two great footballing cities is absolutely fanatical. Earl Barrett, who's new to it all, in towards Ferguson, who was leading on and has conceded the free kick. The giant figure of Duncan Ferguson will obviously be a prime target for Everton crossing and passing today. Ferguson is onside, but the ball will just bounce away from him. But there's more to Duncan Ferguson than just his height and weight. He's a very accomplished footballer for a big man. Four blue shirts in the middle, and the cross disappointing. Manchester United doing the best to cool the fire with which Everton have begun this game, but they're a handful at the moment, the home team. There's a push there by Sharp on Barlow. It's a good free kick. Everton are beating Barlow very cleverly with those long diagonal balls from Hinchcliffe, who will now go over to take this free kick. It's towards Parkinson. Ferguson's there. Michael claims that's the menace of an Andy Hinchcliffe free kick, hit with pace and a low trajectory. Watson's header will fall for Hughes. Told to his left. Hughes will go alone. And it needed the feet of his Welsh international colleague Southall to deny it. Everton have had most of the game in these opening 10 minutes, but that's the clearest chance so far. Headed by Watson. Ince. Hughes will get another chance to cross. Four years ago, next week, Ryan Giggs made his debut for Manchester United against Everton, ironically. An awful lot has happened to him in the meantime. Everton sub today, Daniel Amakachi in the cap, and Vinny Samway is just in front of him. £5 million plus in transfer value. Chase. developing Roy Keane. And here's Hughes. Now, the kindest thing you can say on behalf of Mark Hughes was that the ball did drop from behind Andy Hinchcliffe, who lost the trajectory of the cross completely, and Hughes lost the ball completely. Mark Hughes on the volley didn't even make any connection. Edwards, Lempart, on towards Barlow. Pretty feverish stuff, particularly when Everton have it. They're looking to play the game at a fast tempo. Manchester United desperate to try and settle it down. It's a battle of styles as well as wills. Everton have a free kick. Hinchcliffe with a free kick. Oh, off of Schmeichel! And it almost popped out of his hands for Anders Limpar. A dropped catch, which the Dane got away with. Well, there was a chance there for Limpar, fleetingly. For Everton since that nail-biting game here against Wimbledon at the end of last season. Brian Kidd, Alex Ferguson's right-hand man, a former Everton player. He had a little over a year with Everton under Gordon Lee in the late 70s. Hinchcliffe again, it's perfect for Barlow. What a weapon that is. Horn in support. Ferguson trying to get there. Might come for Everall. Schmeichel did just enough. The original contest between Ferguson and Bruce was a difficult one to call. They were both standing their ground at very least. They both wanted to be in exactly the same spot and Bruce wouldn't let Ferguson get there. Here come Everton again with Barrett. Giggs got back again, not for the first time in this match. Leclerc. Dennis Irwin looking for Andy Cole. Hunter have got there, it's still Cole! The words I was about to say were, he scored, but incredibly, Andy Cole missed the target. And that is the kind of ball played in front of him, which he thrives on. Didn't miss by much, but he missed. And then Park forward to Horde, who made a good run. This is Ferguson. Duncan Ferguson's ability to carry the ball into the box, which made it, rode the challenge from Keane, and John Everall lifted it in over the crossbar. Over a year since he scored, not the strongest suit in his hand by any means in his goal scoring. Got ahead of him here. Ball kick. Final minute of the first half. Everton's hearty approach and some sound tactics have certainly given their fans moments of hope in this first half. Hope's always high when Hinchcliffe's taking a corner. Michael in command though. Took Manchester United a little time to come to terms with the nature of the Everton threat today, but they've done it pretty well. Ends forward. Watson's header. Parkinson's clearance. Last action of a combative first half. Both sides have had their moments. Both sides have gone about it in different ways. Everall and Cole have had the best opportunities, but the fact that neither could take them means we're still scoreless. Alan Hansen, I know, is a great believer that away form ultimately wins you championships. Well, Manchester United haven't lost a Premiership game away from Old Trafford since October the 8th. 10 trips without a quiet bus home. It was a quiet plane home from Norwich on Wednesday night. I gather they had a bit of a bumpy ride in the wind. They had a bumpy ride early on in this game too, but Manchester United have settled pretty well. Up to Everton to try and ruffle their feathers again. Manchester United unbeaten run currently stands at 13 games since Nottingham Forest beat them at Old Trafford in mid-December. Hinchcliffe. Bruce read that well. Ince looking for Cole. He's all alone for now. Got company in the shape of Parkinson all of a sudden. Ince to Giggs. And now Ince. Cole is free. Got by the freedom circle. Cole almost got another bite in it. But he's had two clear sights of goal this afternoon, Andy Cole. And his striking rate is usually to tuck at very least one of those away. Barlow, Barrett, came off Keane and then Bruce, and now Ferguson to Lippard. This is the best of passes really from Lippard back to Ferguson. I'm quite sure what he was supposed to do with it. Everall won it very bravely, good advantage play. Ferguson to Lippard. Barry Horn. Oh, it's a screamer! Hit the post and came out. And nothing Schmeichel could do about it. Barry Horn always bending away from Schmeichel. Stuart Barlow. Earl Barrett. Can Everton feed off that near miss? They've got a corner. Fans are certainly making enough noise. Hinchcliffe's corner. Ferguson's there! And Everton are in front. The big man has a big reputation, which is growing by the week. The Everton fans have a real hero. Schmeichel was committed, didn't get there. Ferguson was always the favourite. The player for whom the best part of £9 million has been paid in two transfer deals in the last 2 years or so. A player who is still only 23 years of age, but a player who is finding himself on Merseyside. Hughes. Nice ball for Roy Keane. Away from Hinchcliffe. Still Keane. Oh, Hughes! He missed his kick completely. Giggs. It's come for Owen, but it won't come for Ince. Several sees to that. Now Ferguson. Done well to retain possession, very well. Pallister lets it bounce, wasn't aware the ball was there. Headed for Watson, has fallen for Cole. Hunts with him with a challenge. Diggs against Barrett. Drew two in and then to Sven Pallister. Southall had to make a save. Good wing play that by Ryan Giggs. Didn't over elaborate. Committed two defenders and fed a man with more space, Gary Pallister. Manchester United are making a substitution. Andrei Kanchelskis is replacing Brian McClair. Kicks with the corner. Oof. Paul Ince, who came crashing in at the near post behind Gary Pallister. Both sides pose a threat, don't they, from corner kicks. Both Giggs and Hinchcliffe capable of delivering a devilish ball into the opponent's box. It's Hughes, Cole! He's on the verge of a personal landmark, Andy Cole. His career total stands at 99 at the moment. His striking rate is one every 1.5 games. He is a born goal scorer, but he hasn't been a goal scorer today. Everton is just over a minute away from what will be a very valuable victory if they can sustain it. And a much celebrated victory, you can be sure of that. They're not there yet, though. Watson away. Ball only as far as Sharp. Headed by Unsworth. Irwin down to Kanchelskis. Dennis Irwin. Cole's there! Well, they're not going to get many more chances. We're ticking towards stoppage time. They've had clear sight for the Everton goal today. Well, they haven't taken any of them. And all the noise inside Goodison Park is being made by the home fans. And all the anxiety is being worn on the faces of Manchester United staff, players and supporters. Desperate finish from Manchester United. Cole. Came off Parkinson. Now it's Irwin. Claimed by Southall. And some relief in the shape of Stuart Barlow out on the flank. Manchester United throw though. Barlow again. Ferguson, who looks like the match winner, off in pursuit. Making it difficult all the time for the Manchester United defenders. He's had some very difficult moments in his young career, but it's all coming right for him here. And there's nothing like a victory over Manchester United to put a smile on Merseyside faces. They found another number nine in the best Joe Royal traditions. Big but skillful and capable of winning a match. A victory, Everton's predicament in the danger zone needed. They're a match for anyone here at Goodison Park. Manchester United beaten 1-0 today by Everton.